everybody. It's me, Penny. And tonight I watched this movie. Wasn't that bad, actually. I mean, it had some recognizable names. It had Boris Karloff and Jack Nicholson. Like a super young Jack Nicholson, like with all his hair. So that was kind of a surprise. It's called The Terror. Sorry, I just have to say, have you ever had one of those days, one of those weeks actually, where nothing is going right? I've been having problems with my Wi-Fi and my internet ever since I brought my freaking iPhone 7 because the ear shit stopped working.
I was like, okay, this ain't gonna work. This is not gonna work. So I brought it in and I'm like, I think I'm gonna upgrade. Maybe I'll get an iPhone 11. So I did. And they're like, hey, we have this new plan. It's an alerting plan. And if you go over your data, you don't get charged $15. It'll just slow down. And I'm thinking, okay. Like a dumbass. I don't know what the hell I was thinking. Why would I want my internet to slow down? I didn't even think. Anyway. So I was like, okay, let's do it. So we did it. And guess what? I went over my data like 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks before my next, cycle. So I was out of data for that long. And I was going crazy. It's like, I watch YouTube videos, I like all that shit. It, what gets me through, what got me through the fucking breakup, I mean, I was able to keep myself entertained, didn't have to speak my own thoughts. And so I was like, okay, maybe if I get Wi-Fi.
Okay, stop. Whew, okay. The movie I saw, actually it wasn't tonight, it was like, I saw it like 4 days ago. But I wanted to watch it again because it was kind of like a little bit longer movie than I usually watch, and it had a little bit more shit going on. Starts out, Boris Karloff is in his castle and he's walking around. It looks like he's following this blood spatter on the ground. And this is like the start of the movie before the credits. So he's following it and, kind of a slow pan. He gets to this door or closet, I'm not really sure, but he opens it and it's this jump scare. It's kind of like a dirty old like skull that kind of jumps out at you, but it's covered in shit, like a corpse or something. And I guess it's supposed to be a jump scare. We're supposed to be scared. I wasn't. And obviously Boris Karloff wasn't. I didn't hear him scream, but whatever. And then it cuts to the credits. And so it's like, The Terror. And so it shows the credits. And that was, okay, I did not know what to expect from this movie. Because I did know Jack Nicholson was going to be in one of these movies, but I wasn't sure which one, because I kind of just like skimmed, hold on. This is what I have been reviewing. Classic horrors, and there's like 50 of them. So I've been doing random shit because a lot of these I've seen. Mostly through Mystery Science Theater 3000. I love them. They're so great. And Jack Nicholson is super young and he has all his hair. And, as handsome as Jack Nicholson could be. One thing I forgot to mention is, there's a young Francis Ford Coppola in here before the Ford. So that's a little neat. The movie starts with a young Jack Nicholson, and he's on a horse, and he's dressed like Captain Crunch. So apparently that means he was in the French army. He's going along, he's looking at his compass, and his compass is going berserk. he doesn't know which way is up. So he keeps going on his horse, but the next thing, he wakes up and he's face down on the beach, being covered by the tide, like the tide just coming in. I don't know if he fell asleep on the beach when it was dry and then the tide came in, or if he just passed out. I don't know. But, you know, his horse is still around. It's chilling. So he gets up and he's thirsty. You know, he's at a beach. The only water he could find is the beach water. And all of a sudden, bing, like this fucking bitch appears. She's like this young, beautiful chick with like black hair and pretty eyes, and she's just standing there. It's like the super close up of her, and Jack's like, oh, hey. And he's like, I'm Andre de blah, 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 from the French Revolution. What's your name? And oh yeah, and then he goes, oh God, do you have water? He follows her. So he follows her, and she brings him to this stream. And she's like, oh, it's fresh water from the fucking Blue Danube. I don't know what the fuck. But anyway, he starts drinking it, and he's just like, Then he gets up, and he's all like, you know, you're the first, you know, vagina I've seen in 7 years. And she's all like, oh, how nice. And he's all like, what's your name? And she's like, ha, Elaine. And she fucks off. And so he's just like trying to follow her. And then she brings him to the beach. And so in front of the beach, there's like this stone. It looks like a cave, kind of. So not a cave, it's just like a structure that's kind of like so. And so right in front of the beach. And so she starts walking into the water towards that structure. And he follows after her in the water. And he hears a noise, and it sounds like a bird. He looks up, and it's this falcon. It's like this... It's like, yeah. So it's this falcon, and it's dive bombing and attacking him. And little funny side story. I have a brother, half brother named Falcon. And a half brother named Talon, which that fucking bird was using to fucking scratch this guy's face off. It was like going down and dive bombing him, and like, and he's trying to sucker punch this thing. He does it so many times, and this shit looks real. I mean, this was before CGI, so things didn't look like cheap, shitty cartoons. It was either he was actually punching a real falcon, or they had some really good fake birds, but... This thing was going down, and he was just like, yeah! Like, fucking Sunny Listing this goddamn guy. And I guess this bird got the better of him and just destroyed him, and he fell into the water. Fell into the water, and he, like, KO'd. And then, when he wakes up, and he's on a bed, and he looks up, and he sees that beautiful young girl with the dark hair, and it dissolves, and she turns into this old lady, and she looked like Al Pacino in drag. Like, if Al Pacino won the role of Norman Bates, that's what it would look like. gross. Jack is like, hey, where's Elaine? And the old broad's like, who's Elaine? And he's like, that beautiful young woman I saw. And then this guy named Gustav comes in. Well, Gustav sees visions too. So the old lady says that Gustav's mind is warped. And she says, what the Lord giveth, he taketh away. So, okay. Gustav is just this guy, and I guess he's just, the light's not on upstairs. Jack is just like asking about this girl. And she's like, yeah, there's no girl. Sorry. So Jack ends up staying over at, again, Al's place. He was sleeping and he gets woken up by a noise. And he looks over and he sees that bird, the falcon, munching on a white mouse. So, like a pinky in the brain. He's not taking over the world now. He's getting digested. He follows this bird, and the bird flew out the window. And so Jack mullocks the bird. Mullock means follows. Sorry. Inuit words. And, so he goes after this bird, and the bird takes him to Elaine, and he goes up to Elaine, he touches her, and he's like, you are real. Super slow, he's standing there, and there's this ethereal, beautiful woman slowly walking towards him and gives him this kiss, and I couldn't help but notice it reminded me of The Shining, when the beautiful woman steps out of the bathtub and walks towards Jack Nicholson and gives him the same kiss, and then turns into an old
corpse.
So he doesn't turn into an old corpse, but they do kiss, and when they stop, that is when he follows her. She walks away, and he mullocks her, and so he keeps walking, and then all of a sudden, boom, Gustav is all up in his face. And Jack is like, what the fuck? Fucking cockatus blockatus, like, what the hell? And the guy is like, dude, look behind me. And so Jack takes a look and he sees this boiling shit on the ground. And he's like, quicksand, that girl was trying to kill me. And Gustav is, she knows not what she do. The lights are on, but she's not home. The lights are on, but you're not home. You're mine, not your own. And you have to break her of this spell. And Gustav's like, you gotta go to the castle or the Baron, whatever lives, and look for Eric. And Jack's like, okay, sounds good. He goes to sleep. The next day, he asks the lady, the old lady, where he can find this castle. And she's like, I'm not telling you where to find this castle. And he's like, it's okay. I will ask Gustav. He will tell you where to find this castle because I need to go. And she's like, all right. Fuck off then. So they go on, they keep going for this castle, and they get to it, and Jack's like, no answer. Doo, 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 doo. No answer. So finally he's like, I'm Andre de blue de blue, something Frenchy. I'm from the something something, better let me in the name of the French magistrate or whatever. Finally the door opens and the head pops out and it is Boris Karloff. And Boris goes, who are you? And Jack goes, I'm Andre de bloobity wobble. And he's like, in the name of the French something or other, you gotta let me in. And Boris is all like, all right, fine. So Jack comes in. And then Boris is all like, so where are you going to be staying? In some village inn, something, something. And Jack's like, hey, I fought in the French Revolution. I think I deserve a place here. I mean, it's only fair. And Boris is like, fine, whatever. And he brings him in, and they sit down, and Boris is like, some cognac? Sure, why not? Boris's servant comes over, and his name is Stefan, and Boris calls him Stefan. He's like, Stefan, can you bring us the cognac for me and my guest, please? And so he does. And then they talk for a while, and then Boris is like, Stefan, show our guest to his room. Oh yeah, so Jack asks Boris if there is a young woman there named Elaine. And Boris is like, no. And they walk into the castle, and there's this gigantic portrait of this beautiful, well, it's a beautiful young lady, but it could be any beautiful young lady. It's just kind of a, I don't know. I thought it was just kind of a generic picture of some chick with dark hair. Anyway, but Boris is like, is this who you're talking about? And Jack's like, yes, that is her. And who is she? And Boris is like, she's been dead for 20 years. And then Jack's like, well, for a dead chick, she sure is spry. And Boris is like, who is my wife? I used to be married to some other broad and she died. So one day I was looking out my window and I saw this young, beautiful peasant girl. So I married her. And then what happened? And Boris is like, well, what happened was I was married to her for like, maybe, I don't even think it was a year. I forgot what he said, but he's like, and then I got called off to serve in the military. So he went off to do his duties. He's been gone for a year. And he finds his wife with another man. Boris murders her. He just straight up murders her. And Jack's like, what happened to the guy? Boris is like, I had Stefan come and, you know, take care of him. Jack's like, okay, sounds kosher. Stefan brings him to his room and he goes to sleep. Jack goes out looking for this chick. I think it's time for a refill. Got my wine. Jack is looking, he's looking at the picture that he drew of Elaine. And as he's doing that, he hears a click. And he runs over to the door and is locked from the outside. And so he threatens this whatever the fuck. You better open this door or else, meh. And it opens. So Jack goes out looking for Elaine. And he comes upon this crypt. And it says on there the Baroness Von whatever the fuck. Anyway, so he sees it and he wants to open it. So the horse that he rode in on is in this corral, and the horse is kind of freaking out because there's a storm, and the storm is like really loud, and there's a lot of like lightning and shit. And the horse is like, meow. I guess the horse gets out. And he goes back to his room, and that portrait that he had drawn was ripped. Somebody ripped it in half. The Boris, by the way, like, I didn't think about that until I watched this movie a second time just to, because it had been a few days since I had last seen it, and I wanted to get, you know, kind of everything. I kind of forgot that Boris Karloff was the voice, like he was the narrator for How the Grinch Stole Christmas. The original animated one, the good one. I just love How the Grinch Stole Christmas. The film cuts to the Boris talking to Stefan.
Jack.
Oh, here's another kind of funny thing I thought. So Boris called him Stefan, but Jack called him Stefan. It's like, oh, he went from this, you know, like exotic the fun to, so Jack Nicholson's supposed to be French and he's like the most American fucker ever. And he's calling this guy Stefan. Hi, her Stefan. Whatever. And that's not the last time names are kind of fucked in this movie.
I'll get back to that.
Jack goes over to Boris and he's like, hey, where's what's your face? And he's like, Boris is like, I don't know what you're talking about. There's nothing here but an old man's memories. Boris is telling Stefan, you know, this guy, he's gotta go. He's worn out his welcome. Get him out of here. Stefan is like, okay, I'll go out to the village and get him a horse so he can get the fuck out. So Boris continues to eat his plate of nothing. So there's a scene, there's this cliffside and in front of the ocean, and Elsa is standing there. And Gustav comes over to her. And he's like, starts calling her Elsa. And she's like, who the fuck's Elsa? I don't know that name. Gustav tells Elsa Andre So Jack is the only person that can help you. Jack goes out looking for Elsa. And he comes upon a cabin that the old lady lives in. So he goes and looks in the window and he sees the old lady, and Elsa is in a chair, and the old lady is walking around her and chanting this spell or whatever. I don't know. She's like just hypnotizing this girl. Gustav is the one that sees the old lady hypnotizing Elaine. So he goes to her. You are Katerina the Heretic. You were tossed out of the village. Like, how long have you been living here? And she said, 2 months. He's like, no, I don't think so. I think you've been here a lot longer than that. And he's like, I'd say like 2 years. And she says, she's like, do you know who this place used to belong to? He's like, who? And she said, Eric. They haven't perfected the jump scare yet. But they did a, like, I wonder if they were, if this was one of the films that kind of started that stupid trend. I'm not a big fan of jump scares. I don't have a very great, okay, so in the Inuit language, we have a word for this. It's called tupuk. And if you tupuk, it's like a, like you startle. Like whatever the fuck you see startles you. And I don't get startled very easy. I don't tupuk very easily. And many have tried and failed miserably. And I don't mean to brag. I have been jump scared before. It'll come to me, but I know I have. Oh, I was probably like, I'm guessing maybe 10 years old. This one night, we're going to bed. And the way our room was set up, my sister and I had the upstairs room. And her bed was on the top, her bunk bed was on the top, mine was on the bottom. And I went up there, not suspecting a fucking thing. Starts getting ready for bed, goes over to my bed. And these fucking hands came out of nowhere under my bed and grabbed me by my ankles. I literally shot up, probably is high as the top bunk bed. My feet, I flew so far up in the air. I kid you not. I was probably, I felt like I was like 10 feet in the air. That fucking bitch. I think she killed all the tupuk out of me. And Gustav is, this is what I was getting at. Elsa, so, you know, the old lady and them, they were calling him Gustav, and she goes, Gustav, Jack and his, Stefan, and that bird, that fucking falcon, comes out of nowhere, comes down, and claws the fuck out of this guy, just like, yeah, no more eyeballs for this guy. So Jack starts snooping around the castle, and he goes into this one room, and it has a lot, it has a drawer, and he's like, buck-ucking, sorry, that's the word for, snooping around, and sneaking into things, you know. So Jack goes up to Gustav. And he says, Elsa loves you, and you're the only one that can help her with this thing. It's like, okay. So later on that night, he goes out and finds her. That first night that Jack went out, he had found her crypt. And Jack wanted to get into that, but Stefan's key couldn't get him into there. So he's like, do you have a crowbar? And they could not find a crowbar or couldn't get them in. I don't know, but whatever. They still could not get into that crypt. So they don't know, like, if that's her body in there or what. But Jack can definitely, you know, she feels like a real person to him. He's sitting out with fucking Miss Ghosty. And he's like, let's leave. And they try to leave that little graveyard. And as soon as he looks away and turns back, she's gone. Bitch fucks off. She's gone. And he's like, what? Gustav comes over to him and he's like, remember when I told you that he killed, the Baron killed Elaine, Elsa. Her name was Elsa. So when they were young and the Baron went away for the war and he was gone for a year. And when he came back, he found Elsa in the arms with another. Jack's like, yeah, I remember that story. And Stefan says, Eric was the other. And it's nighttime and he goes to her and she's like, at night, I get cold. She's like, my shoulders and my back get cold. No shit, Sherlock. If you're outside, you get cold. Anyway. She's like, I'm possessed from the dead. She keeps talking about being possessed by the dead, by being this and that from the dead, and blah, 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 the dead. She cannot get away from that shit. When they had brought the old lady in, and kind of shows Jack in, and Jack looks around. Did you have a baby? Because there was like this little cradle and shit. The Baron, or Boris, like pops into. Victor is in the crypt, and he's talking to Elsa. And he says, he's talking about how much he loves her and blah, blah, blah. And she says, you must do it, Victor. You must do it. If you love me, you will do it, Victor. The ghost, whatever she is, tells him, we will only be together once Stefan opens the thingy in. It floods. The crypt floods. They'll be together because they'll be dead. Elsa, she tells the Baron that take your hand as you took mine. Don't forget, while she's been a ghost, she's been calling him Victor this whole time. Turns out, the Baron was Eric the whole time. Twist! The old lady. He killed my son, Eric. The Baron is actually Eric. And the old lady's like, no! Because that crypt is about to be engulfed in water. Everyone's gonna die that's in that crypt.
So the old lady gets struck by lightning and she bursts into flames.
The Baron and the ghost lady are like fighting. It's like a fair fight. I don't know if he's so old that he cannot. I don't want to say women are weak or anything, but it's a fucking ghost lady. I mean, don't you like go through a ghost? The Baron was talking to the ghost and he's like, she's like, open my crypt and look inside. And he looks inside. She looked fine to me. She just looked a little crusty, you know, like, you know, same supple skin, just a little shitty makeup on top. But she didn't look like she's been dead a very long time. Even if it was for like real life corpses, for that corpse to look the way it did, she would have had to been frozen or only dead for like 3 days, maybe. But when he looks at her, he's like, So he ends up having this little struggle with the ghost lady. And of course he loses. But in that scuttle, Jack manages, because of like the whole water coming in because of the flood thing, Jack manages to rescue Elsa. So he rescues Elsa. He takes her outside and she's alive, but she's just a little, you know, wet, a little soggy. And then he kisses her. She's just laying there. And it's what it looks like, peanut butter all over her face. And the peanut butter is just going down and dripping all over her face. And he continues to stare. He stands up and he hears a sound. It's like a screaming sound. He looks up and it is the fucking falcon. The falcon screaming its ass off. And he's like, oh, that fucking thing. My old nemesis. And then the peanut butter eventually turns into a skeleton with peanut butter on its stupid face. And then it's the end. So I guess that was supposed to be scary. I guess back then it would have been scary. All right, so what I got out of this movie. I actually enjoyed this movie a lot more than the ones I have. Except for I loved the King of Zombies. That one was pretty good. I don't think I gave that one a rating. But this one, you know what, it had some star power. And it did have a lot more action than some of them did. I think I want to give this one maybe a 6. I'd give it a 6. 6 out of 10. I feel like they tried to be scary and it really was not. This whole movie, there was nothing scary about it. Not the ghost chick, not the jump scares that were lame. But the acting was decent. So that was The Terror. I hope y'all enjoyed it. You have a good night. Don't get terrified.